Seeing patients suffering until it came at a certain point where the task force was arbitrarily formed and we expected certain official communication, nothing. And then until when today our leader communicated to us that our risk allowance is proposed to be 60,000. And then we are wondering where that communication comes from. And we just need a very simple address from her. How did she come with the risk allowance of 60,000? And we are just here to get a communication from the director and gives us the formula she used to come up with, 60,000 risk allowance for nurses. Over there, clarifying the task force, nurses, doctors, screening, isolation. For us, we don't know how they calculate. The worst still is that since the work started, they have never rested in isolation. Where the patients admitted, none of the hospital administrators have rested there. And we have all along been struggling with how to design the place. So today, let her come and explain very clearly the terms and conditions. That's why we are here. There's one patient they have brought. He's still there in the ambulance. The doctor, the fourth patient, is still there in the ambulance, parked in front of our isolation room. So we actually, she's over delaying our time because we want to go and ask the patient in. The patient's innocent. So
we have been having some little bit of a challenge, and some of the challenge actually comes with the health workers. Their anticipation, some of them did not look at it as a service, but they looked at COVID as a source of additional income. It is true, government sent us money for COVID activities, which is to the tune of 272,296,000. The risk allowance, we got a communication. This risk allowance comes in, is supposed to be paid in three categories. There is a category which gets 80,000, there is a category which gets 60,000, and a category which gets 50,000.